If you want to record yourself into GarageBand on your iPad, there are a few options open to you. In this video, I'll share three ways that you can record audio into GarageBand on your iPad. By far the quickest and easiest way to get audio into GarageBand on your iPad, whether that's spoken word or vocals or an acoustic instrument, is with the built-in microphone. Every single iPad model has a built-in microphone somewhere on its body. On this iPad Air 2 model, for example, the microphone is situated next to the volume buttons with a second noise-cancelling microphone next to the camera. This iPad Pro model has two microphones on the top edge and two noise-cancelling microphones, one next to the camera bump and one on the bottom edge. The quality you can get from your iPad's built-in microphone will vary depending on the model, but overall it isn't going to sound all that professional. It'll definitely do in a pinch though. You will lose a lot of frequencies recording this way, which can leave your recordings sounding a wee bit thin, especially on the regular iPad models. Results will be better on iPad Pro models, and in fact, Apple added studio quality microphones onto its latest iPad Pro model. That's the 2020 version at the time of this recording. So essentially, the newer the model, the better quality recording you'll get from the built-in microphone. If you're finding this video helpful and want to see more just like it, let me know by showing me some thumb love down below. The USB microphone market has exploded in recent years. The rise in popularity of streaming, YouTube, and home recording has meant the simplicity of USB microphones plug-and-play setup is a great solution for many, especially beginners. You have a lot of choice when it comes to selecting a USB microphone. Brands like Blue, Apogee, and Audio-Technica all make great mics that will give higher quality recordings when compared to your iPad's built-in microphone. Now, regardless of what iPad model you have, if you want to use a USB microphone to record audio into GarageBand, you're going to need to embrace that dongle life. If your iPad has a Lightning connection, you'll need Apple's camera connection kit. If your iPad has a USB-C connection, you'll need a USB adapter. I like this one from Anchor. This Blue Snowball is a budget USB microphone that strikes a good balance between sound quality, build quality, and affordability. This is the Blue Snowball. Because the Blue Snowball captures a much wider range of frequencies than the built-in microphone on your iPad, polishing up audio recorded with it is much easier and results in a much more pro-sounding final product. If you have a Lightning-based iPad, you may run into some issues when it comes to powering some USB microphones. I go into more detail on that issue and show you how to deal with it in this video. So check it out if you want to find out more. The final and arguably best way to record audio into GarageBand on your iPad is with an XLR microphone and an audio interface. Again, you have a huge amount of choice when it comes to what microphone and interface to go for. For this demo, I'm using the Rode NT1 condenser microphone attached to the budget-friendly M-Audio M-Track Solo that's going into my iPad Pro with the same USB-C adapter I showed earlier. Some things to consider here if you want to record using a condenser microphone like the Rode NT1A, you're going to need an audio interface that has 48 volt phantom power, which the majority do have nowadays, to be fair. Using phantom power requires more power, so again, you may run into issues if you have a lightning-based iPad. I cover the issue of powering an audio interface with a lightning-based iPad in the video up here, if you want to check that out. And yes, you absolutely can use dynamic microphones like this SM58 here to record great sounding vocals or instruments as well. Personally, I would use a microphone like this in a studio setting to mic up an electric guitar amplifier as opposed to an acoustic instrument though. Alright, that's three ways that you can record audio into GarageBand on your iPad. I go in depth on how to use an audio interface with your iPad in this video. So give it a click if it sounds like that'll be up your street. Take care of yourself. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.